Namaskar, this is Aditya. Are you wondering how to own a house but not pay any expenses from your pocket? Then this video is for you. When someone told me a few years ago, before I got started in real estate, that I can live for free, I didn't believe it. But trust me, it's definitely possible, because now I believe it, because I lived for free in a couple of my houses when someone else paying my rent. That's the thing. Actually, there is a term for it. It's a Bigger Pockets community invented a term called house hacking. House hacking. When I heard that, like, what the freaking house hacking is? So basically what it means is, if you buy a house, either single family with a basement suite or a two-unit building. So technically it's one house, but you have two self-contained units, or a triplex where you have three self-contained units, or a fourplex where you have four self-contained units. You live in one unit, you rent out other three units, and that rent will pay your mortgage and expenses. So that's the concept. Because, you know, in a traditional life, everyone look for a house for them to live in. Of course, that's a straight way, you pay all your expenses. But this is a freaking concept where you can literally have someone else pay your mortgage while you living there for free. Exactly, I did the same. I purchased a duplex where I had one bedroom unit and three bedroom unit. Me and my wife, we need, you know, for us, the one bedroom unit was more than enough. We lived in one bedroom unit and rented out the three bedroom unit. At that point, this was in 2017, the three bedroom unit was rented for $1,200. And that $1,200 was enough to pay all our mortgage amount and expenses like property tax, insurance, and we had actually extra money. So that was freaking awesome. Like when I applied that, literally my mind blew away, because all of a sudden you're building an asset where someone else paying your expenses. So that's freaking cool. But what's the downside of having a house hacking? So the biggest con, like, you know, biggest downside is, now you have to bear with the tenants. You're living in that house and you have tenants, you have to bear with them. So first 3 months I rented out, you know, that place by myself. Me and my wife, we ran the Kijiji ad and rented the place for someone. And we always, like, the tenant always used to come and call, knock the door and say, hey, we have this problem. Hey, we have that problem. I'm like so frustrated. And again, sometimes you might find good tenants. But then later on, what I did is, like, literally, you know what? I don't want to deal with tenants. I gave that unit for a property management company. Literally, they took care of everything. And I don't even think the tenants know that we are the homeowners. So now it becomes hands-on. You know, of course, I pay like few I was paying 8% of my rent. And also, like, my rent increased a little bit, because now when they leased out for a new tenant, the rent has increased. So that's, again, I will make another video on pros and cons of using a property management company. But what I'm trying to say is, yes, there is some, you know, challenges that you have to deal with when you have a tenant in the house. But if you're like me, if you want to save the cost for mortgage, you know, bear with it for a few months or a year or two until you can find another property for you to move in. Now you just save your money and, you know, buy another property. Now both the units rented out, you make some cash flow and you can live in another house, like what I'm doing right now. Even this house, I have another unit, but I recently, my tenants moved out and I decided not to rent anymore. But long story short, that's a whole concept. You have someone else paying your mortgage. So live for free. If you're like me, new to country, you want to save, pay your debts, you know, if you have debits, if you want to, like, have a freedom, then house hacking is the concept to go with. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below about house hacking or mortgage or any other part. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And if you have done house hacking, let me know how was your experience, because I'm curious to hear other stories. And if you like this content, hit that thumbs up button, because that's the fees you pay for my time in educating you. So with that, thank you so much and see you in the later videos.